now, Mickey Mouse proudly presents The Mouse Factory.
Punching in here at the Mouse Factory. And we sure got a busy half hour going here. What with bullfights, baggage room, bad guys, bears, and bullfrogs. So we better get moving.
Excuse me, Senor Buttram. I couldn't help but notice that intricate pass. What do you call that?
I call this shaking the taco crumbs off of the cape.
I see. Could you explain to us the principles involved in bullfighting?
Huh? Well, let's see. There's the matador, the picador, and the torador, and the most important one of all, the exit door.
Could you show us some of your favorite passes with the cape?
By all means. Now, this is the Veronica. Now, this is the half Veronica. And this is the Ribolero. That's a fancy one. But my all-time favorite is the Pasa de la Buttram.
The Pasa de la Buttram?
Let me demonstrate. Now, first, you pull your elbows into your sides like this. Then you point your toes in and your knees. And then you stick your thumb in your mouth like this.
That subdues the bull?
No, but it sure makes him feel sorry for me. Excuse me. My public awaits me. Tacos! Get your tacos! Red hot tacos here! Get your tacos! Looks like real trouble to me.
Bashful.
Yes, my luck. Didn't sell a taco. My first day, and they send in a sissy bull. Did you know that the pronghorn antelope is capable of speeds up to 60 miles an hour? And that's without high-octane gasoline. People was blaming the railroad for driving off the buffalo herds. Now the buffalo's doing fine and the railroads are becoming extinct. But you know, people still ship all sorts of stuff by railroad. An experienced station master like myself, he can tell what's in each side of these pieces without hardly trying. Now, for example, this is a five-piece set of genuine chinaware. You better make that a 5,000-piece set of chinaware. No question about this one, belongs to a Wild West show. Oh, my. Something's missing. There's supposed to be a magician's trunk around here that's to go out on the next express. Oh, there it is. Hey, Goofy, come here. Here. Now make sure that this trunk gets on the next train. And don't goof.
Oi, oi, sir.
Hey, you know the rules. No pets on the job. That sissy bull. There's definitely something fishy going on out there.
Thank you.
The train is coming. Magician is gonna do a short performance tonight. Did you know the otter is the only member of the weasel family that's equipped with webbed feet? Ain't that just ducky? Step up, neighbors, don't be shy. Come and be the first to buy Professor Buttram's famed elixir, the world's greatest ailment fixer. Puts an end to aching back, stuffy head, or gout attack. Take it when you're feeling dizzy, out of sorts, or in a tizzy. Now, who'll be the first to buy? Here's a gent that's gonna try. This'll put your ills at ease. That'll be a dollar, please. Thank you, friend, and you can bet that's $1 spent you won't regret. Now, come on, folks. I sense disbelief that this can bring you quick relief. Why, just observe our friend, the Bruin. Hey, what the devil are you doing? Don't panic, folks. What you detect is just a minor side effect. No need for concern or cares. It only works that way on bears. Be the first to try the best bear repellent that money can buy. Did you know the three most popular domestic animals in the world are the dog, the cat, and the horse? And husbands ain't even on the list. You know, this is the kind of outfit I wore in over 200 Western pictures. And that's a lot of horseshoes, believe me. I worked in so many of them odors, every time I dress like this, I look around to see if there's a water trough I'm gonna fall into. That meant, of course, I never got the girl. But when you ride a horse, feed a horse, sleep with a horse, it's pretty hard to get a girl to even come near you. One thing about them old Westerns, there was no mistaking the good guys from the bad guys. The hero was always the one in the white hat like this. And the bad guy, he always looked like he washed his clothes in Brand X. And here's where the bad guys always wound up, Boot Hill. They called it that because there's so many heels ended up here, I guess. Hey, just look at some of these old markers. The good times were loved by a thief named Marty, so the town folk threw him a necktie party. Here lies the body of Bartender Bill. He died as he lived with his hand in the till. And a crooked dentist named Cyrus McGee lies here a-filling his last cavity. Of course, you had to catch the bad guys before you could bury them, and that wasn't too easy. They was slicker than greased eels. Well, just look at them. Jesse James, Billy the Kid, Black Bart, the Dalton Gang, and this one, the orneriest one of them all, Peg Leg Pete. Let's take a look at what led to his downfall.
Such a big bundle for such a little lady. You need some help? No?
Thank you, sir. I reckon I can take care of myself.
That the moose has the largest antlers in the world and the smallest unklers? You know, when I first left the country and come to the city, I got a room near the factory so I could live near my work. I just couldn't stand the smog, all that noise and racket. So then I figured the answer was one of these new high-rise apartments in the city. Well, it had fires, robberies, accidents, and more apartments. So then I moved to the suburbs where folks can do their own things, raise a family, maybe some dogs and cats. So then I decided maybe it's better just to move back to the country, where at least a fella can get a decent night's sleep. Ah, listen to that soft symphony of summer sounds.
Mm-hmm.
No matter where you live, there's nothing like the peace and quiet of those long winter nights.
Old tomcat with his meow meow, old hound dog with his bow wow wow.